another drink, it'll make you feel better. Have another drink and you'll feel alright. If you feel down and you're under the weather, have another drink and you'll feel alright.
Well, Jimmy Santangelo, Jimmy the Wine Guy, he is here to talk about rum. Of course, Jimmy is the proprietor of the Wine Academy of Utah, and he dropped off this delicious rum, the real McCoy rum, at our houses. And I've tweeted a picture of my cocktail. If you can go at RFHBill, and you can see a couple of my vintage radios in the picture as well.
And great shot, Jimmy.
I need Jimmy to tell me how to mix this up.
Yeah, I haven't mixed mine yet. I wasn't sure what the proportion should be. Well, let's start from the beginning, and then we'll get to the mixing and all that.
Talk about the real McCoy rum.
Absolutely. Good morning, everyone, and happy Halloween weekend. This real McCoy rum is made by Foursquare Distillery in Barbados. That's a series of islands there in the tropics. You've got Jamaica, you've got Cuba, you've got Martinique. All these islands that are rum producers, but each island kind of has their own specific style. And the Foursquare Distillers is multi-generational distiller, and the real McCoy is part of the rums in their portfolio. They've been making rum for five generations, and like Gina mentioned, Bill McCoy was a rum runner during Prohibition up along the East Coast in the United States, distributing rum, you know, during a time when it was taken away from us during Prohibition. And the real McCoy, I distributed to you all the 5-year as well as the 12-year. And the 12-year is to be drunk neat, and we'll get to that. But the 5-year rum is, what the 5 years is, that it's been aged in oak barrel for that full 5 years. And the oak barrels that they're using are ex-bourbon casks. So you really draw a lot of those characteristics from the barrel, those toasty notes, a little bit of toffee comes through. And rum in general has those characteristics of banana and tropical fruit. But when they're aged and when they're really treated well, you start to get those toasted notes.
Now this smells terrific.
So I just put some glass, some ice in a glass. I poured however much rum that was that you gave me in that
all
little jar.
2 ounces.
How much was it? Yes.
Put all of that in one drink?
Yes.
Jimmy, what is the proper recipe for this?
Well, that's a 2-ounce pour I gave everyone of rum. So with the pineapple juice there, give it a little shake because that's unfiltered pineapple juice. I love that stuff when mixing cocktails.
Okay.
Nice, big, rich, and fresh pineapple juice. It balances the acidity you get with pineapple juice with the natural sweetness that comes through.
Jimmy, Gina was once again shaking her finger at me. She was once again shaking her finger at me. There was nothing wrong with pouring that whole 2 ounces over the ice and then adding the pineapple juice, is there?
It's a good ratio. It's a good ratio. And you can use the equal parts there, Gina and Carrie, because I think you're making yours now.
Yeah, it's
so
one.
Just kind of fill it up. Give it a little stir. I gave you a fun decorative umbrella just to have fun with that. If hopefully the pineapple juice is cold, or if you have a cube in there. If not, it's okay. And give that a little sippy sip. And you'll find that the rum and pineapple juice are just a natural pairing combination. They really complement one another well.
And it's delicious. The reason I drank mine yesterday was because I didn't want to just take a little sip of it this morning and then let it get all watered down and everything.
I mixed it just with a sip. Just, you know, I did a splash of rum and a splash of pineapple, just enough for a taste.
But you need the umbrella. Delicious. None of you have the umbrella.
Go look at the picture I posted. Can you put that picture up on radio from
the umbrella gets TV? It gets in the way when you're drinking.
Yeah, I poked my eye with it, as a matter of fact.
See, it's just you can't do it.
X96.com/live. You can see us trying to maneuver this. Now, what would you call this drink? Just pineapple juice and rum, or does it have a name? Or?
Yeah, it's It's a drink that we created, and it's not something that's too unique, but we used to have it back in Buffalo, New York, when we'd go each year to the Yagata Regatta along the Niagara Falls Peninsula right there, and it was all these speedboat races.
It's called the Yagata Regatta.
Yeah, yeah, it was the big regatta race, and we would just have rum and pineapple juice because it was super easy. Because you're standing out there along the side edge, there were no bars and restaurants, or you were on your own boat watching it. So,
I'll have a regatta. What is it again? Regatta.
Yagata Regatta.
Yagata Regatta.
While sitting at the bar of the Borgata. Okay.
Mm-hmm. There you go.
Well, listen, you know, Jimmy, I used to drink rum, and then I stopped. I just thought, that's not doing anything for me. I may go back to rum because this stuff was delicious.
It's really good.
It's
really nice.
Yeah.
I don't know if you had a chance to taste that or smell that 12-year, but
no, here
that
I go.
Is a full 12 years in barrel.
I drank it.
Yeah.
Delicious. It's good.
Oh, that sounds wonderful.
Pineapple, bananas Foster, a little bit of cocoa or chocolate, like just deep, rich flavors. Rivals any fine whiskey on the rocks. And
I was
who
amazed.
Don't think about that with rum, right? You always think of rum, you're mixing it with something.
Mm-hmm.
That's a really nice one to compliment anyone's bar shells at home.
That's
I was amazed by it. I just poured it all into a glass and drank it straight, and it was delicious.
And that's called
Your inner pirate on.
Yeah, that's Real McCoy 12-year, it says.
Mm. Mm-hmm. I think it's 100 proof.
Wow, that's good.
It's good.
It's so smooth.
So, Jimmy, can you get this, the Real McCoy rum, at the state stores?
Yes, it's widely available. You can get both the 5-year and 12-year. 5-year is a great go-to rum to have, mixing drinks. The 12-year is a great one just to have as a sipper. They're widely available throughout the state.
All right. And
these are dark rums, you should point out, because they're different.
That's right.
Yeah. And they do have a clear one as well.
The 3-year that we don't have that one available in the state. That's a little bit more limited in general across the U.S. But if I get a little bottle, we'll have to taste that. Tasty on it.
Mm-hmm. Right. It feels warm in my tummy.
Yes.
Well, I was impressed. I'm going to buy a bottle of the 12-year, and because it's good just drinking without any mix. I don't, I'm not a huge mixed drink fan or a fruit drink fan, really. So I think the 12-year is the thing for me.
And like Jimmy said, that 12-year, it's like sipping a whiskey. It's just delicious. Yeah.
So what do we got, Jimmy? What do we got going on at the Wine Academy of Utah?
You know, a lot of events coming up. We have our in-home events are more popular than ever, where everyone has their quarantine group. So rather than coming out to one of my events, I'm coming to you for an in-home educational wine event. So contact me for that. But also the corporate events are really taking off, virtual tastings, as everyone's trying to figure out how they're going to, as a company, have their company party or holiday party. It's a great way to reach out. I can help coordinate. And whether you're here all in Utah, virtual, an online virtual presentation, or you have clients or your team is across the country, we have a third-party vendor that can ship the wine direct to their door and still accomplish the same goal of a virtual tasting, getting everyone together.
Gina, don't put the umbrella in your mouth. Don't put it in your mouth.
That tastes like rum.
Gina, don't put it in your mouth. You're going to have an accident. Your mouth. Listen, remember, your mouth is what makes you money. So don't.
Jimmy, the Wine Academy of Utah can teach you about wine so that you're not intimidated by it. I had, was wearing my mask out, and somebody asked me, what is the Wine Academy of Utah?
Same thing happened to me, Carrie. I was wearing it at the liquor store, and the guy who was the clerk at the liquor store looked at me and said, we have a wine academy in Utah?
You
He'll teach you not to be you won't be intimidated by this stuff at all if you learn about it.
Yeah.
Thank you, Jimmy.
Well, I appreciate the support. You got it. And enjoy the holiday weekend. Be safe and have some rum.
Oh,
thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Have another drink, it'll make you feel better. Have another
drink, it'll feel all right. Traffic, Gina.